in space. Down here, they come this side. So, next item.
This special sitting started at 10 a.m., attended by the family and friends of the late Keith Muhakanizi, who followed the sitting in the Strangers Gallery.
For someone who was open-minded, focused, direct, decisive, and never feared to speak his mind on matters he regarded as important for our national development, including challenging us as Parliament, especially on issues of budget allocations, more so when we wanted more funds to be appropriated. His contributions towards strong macroeconomic policies will never be forgotten, as they have made an indelible mark on the economic development of our country.
The Prime Minister Robin Nabanja moved the motion for a resolution of Parliament to pay tribute to the late Keith Muhakanizi, former Permanent Secretary, Office of the Prime Minister, and former Secretary to the Treasury.
Parliament collectively conveys its deep condolences to the bereaved family, relatives, friends, and the people of Uganda for the loss of a distinguished and gallant citizen of this country. Two, that Parliament takes cognizance of the immense contribution that Mr. Keith Muhakanizi has rendered to the people of Uganda.
Nabanja highlighted major economic reforms which Muhakanizi championed.
Using his tenure as Permanent Secretary and Secretary to Treasury, he undertook the following key reforms. A, decentralization of processing and payment of salaries, pensions, gratuity and arrears, program-based budgeting and program budgeting systems, public investment management systems, the Uganda Intergovernmental Fiscal Transfer Reform Program.
The motion was officially seconded by the leader of opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, who hailed Muhakanizi as a strong pillar in the economy who propagated budget discipline. Mpuuga did not spare ministers implicated in the Iron Sheet scandal, saying they took advantage of Muhakanizi's illness to flout guidelines and distribute among themselves iron sheets meant for Karamoja.
The country has lost, probably, and I'm using the word probably on purpose, the last break and the controls on a vehicle called irresponsible budgeting. If his breaks were manual, I hope his successors, Mr. Ramadan Gobe and the team, introduce ABS breaks on our budgeting framework in memory of his physical, almost physical efforts to exercise control.
Matia Kasaija, the Minister of Finance, and Major General Jim Muhwezi also spoke out on Muhakanizi's legacy.
We need to copy, especially now I'm speaking to the young professionals, to copy his way of doing things. Having a very versatile mind, he would even produce the law if it requires a law. If it's a policy matter, he would also bring a policy.
He has left a strong legacy, and to the family, we condole you, but we know that he has left you a very, very strong base upon which you, especially the children, can build.
Muhakanizi succumbed to malt organ failure on April 13th in Milan, Italy, and was laid to rest in Kabula, Lyantonde district on 23rd April. Story by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.